Hello friends, in my this video I am going to show you one very important concept, and that is gain bandwidth product of an amplifier with application of negative feedback. Okay, so let us discuss. See, this is one gain versus frequency graph for a audio amplifier for different frequencies. The frequency is varying from 0 to 50k and higher than that, and in y-axis gain is plotted. This is without feedback amplifier. Then you see one thing, that suppose you draw the minus 3 dB line, so it will cut the gain versus frequency graph at two points. This lower frequency point is called lower cutoff frequency or lower 3 dB frequency, or denoted by FL, lower cutoff frequency without feedback, and this is FH, that is higher cutoff frequency without feedback. Okay, so this point corresponds to FH. Now see, the FH value is nearly 10k, okay, that means 10,000, and the lower cutoff frequency is only 20, lower than 20, okay. So what is bandwidth? We know that is bandwidth equal to higher cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. So basically, as FH is very greater than FL, so we can assume that the bandwidth is approximately equal to higher cutoff frequency FH. Okay, so we can put this assumption, and that's what I have written here. Bandwidth of an amplifier without feedback, this is without feedback scheme I told you. This is the general for any case. You take random amplifier, C amplifier, you configure one, you design one amplifier and check in the Bode plot, you will see that the higher cutoff frequency is very larger than the lower cutoff frequency. So indeed this assumption is applicable for any amplifier case, that is bandwidth equal to FH minus FL, which is approximately equal to FH or higher cutoff frequency, because FL is very less than FH. Okay, so this is very important. So what we got, that for general amplifier the bandwidth is approximately equal to higher cutoff frequency. Now see, bandwidth with negative feedback, what we got, the higher cutoff frequency increases by a factor 1 plus beta into A, where A is the gain without application of feedback, and beta is the feedback gain. And if we consider the lower cutoff frequency, then it is decreased by a factor 1 plus beta A. So the new higher cutoff frequency is equal to FH, this is higher cutoff frequency without feedback, into 1 plus beta A, and the lower cutoff frequency FLF, this is with feedback, equal to FL. FL is lower cutoff frequency without feedback. So that is FLF equal to FL by 1 plus beta into A. Now we know generally beta A value is very high. So see, already FH was much greater than FL, but now see, FH increases by a factor 1 plus beta A, where this factor is very high value. This factor has very high value, and FL is divided by this. So lower cutoff frequency is decreased much, so that in this case, obviously, we can put this assumption, that is FHF is much greater than FLF, that is higher cutoff frequency with feedback is much greater than lower cutoff frequency with feedback, so that the bandwidth we can assume as FHF. Okay, so that's what I have written here. Bandwidth of an amplifier with feedback equal to bandwidth with feedback, so BWF is equal to FHF minus FLF equal to FHF. This is approximately equal to FHF. Why? Because FLF is lesser, much lesser than FHF. Clear? I hope it is clear to you. Now see, so basically what we can get, bandwidth with feedback equal to higher cutoff frequency with feedback. So basically that is equal to FH into 1 plus beta A. This thing you know, because of application of negative feedback scheme, what happens? The higher cutoff frequency increases by this factor, Now, the bandwidth without feedback was FH, because the bandwidth without feedback was basically FH minus FL, but as FL is much lesser than FH, so that what we have assumed, that the bandwidth without feedback is approximately equal to FH. So instead of FH, we can put the bandwidth without feedback, and we get this very important relationship, that is bandwidth with application of feedback equal to bandwidth without application of feedback into 1 plus beta A. Clear? Now see one thing, this graph I already explained in my previous videos. This is F1, this is lower cutoff frequency without feedback, this is F2 higher cutoff frequency without feedback, and F2 dash is the higher cutoff frequency with feedback, and F1 dash also is the lower cutoff frequency with feedback. See, when this is the A graph, which is nothing but the gain versus frequency graph without application of feedback. For this case, gain is very high, but bandwidth is lower. And see, for second graph, this graph, this is gain versus frequency graph with application of feedback. For this case, bandwidth is very high. See, for this case, bandwidth is this much amount, and in previous case, bandwidth was only this much amount. So for this case, bandwidth is increased, although the gain is reduced. See, this case gain is this much, but in previous case, midband gain was this much amount. Okay, so basically, you know, due to application of feedback, the gain decreases and bandwidth increases. That's what happening here. Now see one thing, so without application of feedback, consider this case. This is without application of feedback gain versus frequency graph. For this case, what is the gain, midband gain versus midband gain into bandwidth? Okay, that is G into BW. This is gain bandwidth product for amplifier without feedback, and that is equal to G into FH, that is gain into higher cutoff frequency, and here FH is F2. Clear? So we can write in such a way, G into F2. Clear? F2 is this frequency. Clear? Now consider this case. This is with feedback. Now in this case, gain into bandwidth is how much? You know that the midband gain is reduced by a factor G by 1 plus beta A. Okay, now this is gain, and bandwidth is how much? I just told bandwidth with feedback is equal to bandwidth without feedback into 1 plus beta A. What is bandwidth without feedback? That is FH. So FH into 1 plus beta A. Clear? Now see, 1 plus beta A, 1 plus beta A cancels each other, and in this case also we are getting gain bandwidth product as G into FH, which is equal to nothing but G into F2, because FH, that is higher cutoff frequency without feedback, without application of negative feedback, is basically equal to F2. So see, basically for both the case, gain bandwidth product is G into F2, and here also G into F2. So we are getting a very important conclusion, that because of application of negative feedback, although gain changes, although bandwidth changes, but what is happening, gain bandwidth product remains constant. As because of application of negative feedback, gain decreases, bandwidth increases, in such a way that the product of these two remains constant. You can make an analogy with this concept with another concept, whatever you have studied in your physics course. Physics is everywhere. So can we relate this funda with something related to physics? Yes. Think about that. That is nothing but the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Okay. We can relate this thing, this gain bandwidth product, with Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. See, we know from Heisenberg's uncertainty principle that delta x into delta p greater than equal to h by 4 pi, where delta x is the uncertainty in position and delta p is the uncertainty of momentum. So if See, this product is constant. H is Planck's constant. H by 4 pi is constant. So delta x into delta p is basically constant. So suppose delta x increases, delta p will decrease. And suppose delta x decreases, obviously delta p will increase. Okay. So both the two factors cannot increase simultaneously. And if one factor increases, the other factor is decreased in such a way that the two product remains constant. So similarly, here you can make an analogy with this concept with gain bandwidth product. See, delta P means change in momentum, okay? And gain means, suppose you consider voltage gain. So suppose gain increases means voltage increases, clear? I am just saying, just to make an analogy. So suppose gain increases means voltage increases, and if voltage increases, the speed of the electron will also increase. So basically, if speed increases, then we can say that the momentum of the electron will also increase. So basically, we can relate the gain with the momentum. Okay, so as the gain increases, okay, suppose the gain is increased by a very high amount, then obviously what will happen, the suppose analogically we can get the delta P increases. So as delta P increases, delta X will decrease. And we can make an analogy in between delta X and bandwidth. Suppose the bandwidth is much, then obviously with analogy we can find the electrons in the whole area. So obviously delta X will increase. Suppose bandwidth is very less, then we can find the electron in this portion only. So basically delta x will be very small. So basically we can make an analogy in between bandwidth and delta x. So as gain increases, so delta p increases, so delta x decreases. And by analogy we can say the bandwidth decreases. So as gain increases, see, the bandwidth is this much amount. But suppose the gain is decreased, so obviously the voltage, output voltage decreases, so the electron's speed will decrease, so that the electron's momentum will decrease, so that delta x will increase. And as delta x increases, by analogy we can say the bandwidth increases, because bandwidth we can analogically compare it with delta x. So basically when gain is decreased, see, the bandwidth is increased by a much amount. Now the bandwidth is in this portion. Okay, so this Heisenberg's uncertainty principle is applicable in this case also. Okay, so as you remember this concept, this is very important concept for electronics engineering. Gain bandwidth product for negative feedback amplifier is always constant. As gain increases, bandwidth decreases. As gain decreases, bandwidth increases, in such a way so that the gain into bandwidth always remains constant. Okay, and you can make an analogy with Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Clear? This is all for this video. In my next video, I will show you some more concepts. Thank you for watching.